And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Rank Up Sunday. Let's get some good ranking up today. We haven't had the best luck on Sundays recently, but hopefully that will change today. We're going to be starting with Taric Draven, a deck that we've had a lot of success with. I'm not sure, I'm going to kind of question how we will do against this new Twisted Fate Elise deck that's everywhere. I just don't think I've played that matchup before, so that will be one that will be interesting to see how we end up faring there. But then we're going to be playing some other good decks. We're going to return to mid-range Frostbite. It's another great deck. I put together a Fiora Dragons deck that basically just kind of some mid-range dragon cards with Fiora in there, of cards that I want to play, and cards I think that could be good, especially against that Twisted Fate Elise deck. So we'll see how that deck does. And then Winter Draven, another Draven deck that we played a few days ago and was also impressive with Freljord. All right, but anyway, let's start with Taric Draven. We are going to go ahead and go play our five games in ranked. Let's see. So we're starting with 105 LP today. I guess that we can check what spot we are on the leaderboard. 253. All right, we need to bump those numbers up. Those are some rookie numbers. Bump those up. All right, here we go. Let's go play our five games in ranked. All right, so this is basically the new Twisted Elise deck, but they're playing Gangplank instead of Elise, which I think is actually probably better. So I think this is actually just a better version of the Twisted Fate Elise, I think. But we have to play the games to see. Hey, Breeze.
Be nothing left when I'm done.
I don't love that.
I have the best job.
Got a surprise for him.
Bless the faithful and sear the heretics.
So I'm gonna have one pill cascade. You know, it's kind of debate. Like, I could have like spinning axe and then be able to have both pill cascades. But we're just gonna have one.
Never lost a heretic.
Cool card there. Balding Yeti, 16 months. Thank you so much. Keeping that sub going. You are amazing. Thank you, Balding Yeti. Alright, first sub of the day. So that's gonna do 3 damage, right?
Dead in their tracks.
I would really like to draw Taric. This is, like, especially with our how our hand looks. It's a very good Taric hand. I'd like them to stop having Gohards.
Let's boogie.
Yeah, like, this would be a great, great Taric hand. So that's the card we want to see. Taric or Kato the Arm. One health units are the very bottom of the list of cards that I want. The very bottom of the list. Well, their hand's been pretty good.
No one's the wiser.
And we keep drawing one drops, which I said are at the very bottom of the list. Oh, a two drop, I guess. Oh, Taric, where are you? We need you, Taric.
Ours is the one true light.
Keep up, keep up.
I don't think like playing a gem on like the Solari Soul, like playing a gem really matters that much. I think I'm gonna save the gem to like discard to like another, you know, we get another spinning axe here.
I'm gonna gut you.
Clear off.
Easy.
I guess. No, the gem didn't matter. They would just, if I gemmed this Legion Grenadier, they would just block the Legion Grenadier and they would Unspeakable Horror or something else. So no, the gem didn't matter whatsoever. I am out of Pell Cascades.
Deal me in. Soak it in.
Yeah, we didn't get to find a Taric first.
Fuse is lit!
Unseen, unheard.
A game! Go on, then.
Watch the ball, folks.
Jeez.
Whatever, man.
Good hand for them.
My fault.
Man. Like, that could be a problem with our list. Like, the small units don't matter very much in that matchup, like, because they just, you know, trade with Go Hard, Unspeakable Horror, stuff like that. Like, you want bigger things. There you go. Like, you want your Taric, you want your Kato, especially Taric. That's such a important card. We could double up those Pale Cascades and make things tough and things like that. I guess we're gonna mulligan this Might, and I'm gonna keep these. So it's definitely possible we have too many one drops in this deck. We kept on drawing those. Oh, Malbo, we just played against you. Hey, GG's. Yeah, your hand was very good. You had all those go hards right away, and they just matched up perfectly against what I had. And then yeah, Twisted Fate, Gangplank. Good hand.
They would fall by my blade.
So this is why I kept Culling Strike in my opener, was for Fiora. I guess I do need to worry about Sharp Sight. Right, like, so if I go Culling Strike, they could have Sharp Sight. And that would be kind of a mess. Maybe I just play another Mountain Goat.
I have the best job.
Okay, I like Backup Draven.
Let's boogie.
Is this supposed to be a challenge?
So obviously they block and go barrier, we have Whirling Death. There we go, that worked out. Probably means no Sharp Sight. And they didn't want to block. Or didn't want to do anything like that. Okay, so let's go
got access, need
over here. So Pill Cascade's 2 mana. Whirling Death 3. So I can play a gem.
Keep up, keep up.
You better bleed.
I could see them trying to like block and fight. I think they're gonna do that. I want them to fight the, try to find the fight the mountain goat. Not my Draven. I'm gonna level up. All right. Well, I'm going to discard a gem, so I have another spinning axe available. So that's lethal. So I can just pass to them because they got to do something. So they're gonna single combat there. Okay. So do that. All right, GG's. And then I had one spinning axe left in case they had something like a Ranger's Resolve.
Damn, I'm good.
All right, let's play some scouts. So I guess we're gonna go one, then two, then one plus two, and I think that's all good for this matchup. I think we're gonna do that. I would like, you know, like we don't have either of our champions or Kato. Kato's basically our third champion. We basically have three champions: Draven, Taric, and Kato. And I'd like some spells, of course. You know, like want some tricks, like some Pale Cascades. Okay, we found a Taric. I think they probably have Blinding Assault. Yeah, so they wanted me to play a 3-2. We'll take the gem. The gem works with Taric. Gives me something. Okay, never mind. We won't take the gem. Ooh, Might is very good with Taric.
Fuse is lit!
My shield is yours!
Yeah. That Bright Steel Protector is a little annoying, so I'm just going to attack with the two ones. Yep, so that's the plan, is to Taric on four, and then go Might open attack turn five. We should still get a gem. I do need to be a little concerned about, like maybe I have to pass. I do need to be concerned about Sharpsight, I guess. Like if I play Taric, they Sharpsight their Valor and trade.
I bring clarity.
I hope they don't have that. Also considering, you know, with just having this now, definitely considering just going gem on Taric and then playing Crescent Guardian. Okay, yeah, so we definitely have to do that. So we don't get to open attack, of course, with Taric with nothing to support. So we'll go gem and then Crescent Guardian.
Never submit.
That tough is pretty important.
Ah, quit your yapping.
So it'll be them taking nine.
Shield up.
Never mind. Alright, they're gonna take nine, go down to six. I like to see that with having double Might. We can take a hit here, so I don't want to see challengers. Right, like Genevieve, no thank you.
Break their spirits and their swords.
Still a challenger.
Raise your weapon, Sunwind.
Looking for trouble? It found you.
Run them through.
Hardly fair. Okay. 3 out of 7, so I'm not going to be able to make these indestructible. That should still be pretty good.
Don't get ahead of yourself.
So they can go to 1 with this.
There is nowhere left to go but up.
No concerted strike. There we go. GG's.
Beautiful.
Taric is awesome. Ooh, Ezreal Swain. Let's see what we got. We got a good hand. So we'll keep it. That's what you should do with good hands. Keep them.
Explosives prime. Damn it.
Fair enough. The might draw is not going to help too much unless we find Taric. Ah. Okay. I was thinking Mystic Shot. That's why I didn't want to play Mountain Goat. They Mystic Shot Mountain Goat. I like that Guiding Touch, that's a good draw. That worked out pretty well for them. This in general has worked out pretty well for them. Alright, come on, Taric. We need you, Taric. No. I need Taric.
The few for the many.
Throw the 1-1 in front. Yep. Taric. All right, Kato's not bad. Besides that, we have two Captain Farrans in here at the top end. Right? Or do we just have one? Yeah, we have two. Okay, so we want Taric or Captain Farron.
Oh, that's a harvest right there!
Taric or Captain Farron? That is neither. So they're gonna use like a burn spell on whatever I give the overwhelm. I'd rather give it to the Legion Grenadier than the Mountain Goat.
You lack discipline.
So this is them going to 10. Okay, let's see.
moneymakers.
There's Captain Farron.
You hoping they'll die of boredom?
It's them going to two. As them going to zero. I don't think they'll have anything they'll be able to kill Draven or Kato, but they could save two life by killing the Crescent Guardian if they found, you know, they find something that kills the Crescent Guardian. Or I guess something that kills the Grenadier. Oh yeah, I should have done, oh man, I should have done that on the goat, not the Grenadier. I forgot the Grenadier. Oh man, I was just thinking about these two. Oh man, I messed that up. I need to use the transfusion on the goat. I messed that up.
Now we're cooking.
Yeah, I messed that up. I should use it on the goat. Grenadier, the reason why I did Grenadier just in my mind, I just, you know, thought about like, okay, it's good if Grenadier dies is not a bad thing. Yeah, you know, like that's just like the thing that just popped in my mind immediately was Grenadier dying not a bad thing. But yes, I needed to do that on the goat. Alright, but still, they're at three. And we drew Captain Farron, so perfect draw for next turn.
Empire above all.
Yeah, hopefully they don't kill me this turn from 18. I feel like it'll be difficult to do.
Such little lies. I'll break this siege.
But it's not impossible. Yeah, I agree. Yeah, Slayer says that whenever you see a Draven level up animation, that means you probably win, and I think you're right. You don't see very often somebody level up Draven and lose.
Check me out. I thought you'd never ask.
Well, maybe it's not impossible, actually. Maybe it's not. So that would be 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and then, like, if they play like Mystic Shot on, if they have double Mystic Shot on me, that's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 17. Yeah, that's actually exactly 17. So if they have two Mystic Shots, I lose. Which, all they need is just one Mystic Shot, because then they just... Okay, that is not going to kill me. Yeah, I guess all they needed was one Mystic Shot, because then that would have stunned both of these, and then their Ezreal makes a new Mystic Shot. So yeah, all they needed was Mystic Shot, and they would have killed me. Their Ezreal wasn't leveled up until they played. Once they played their Static Shock, then their Ezreal leveled up. It wasn't leveled up beforehand.
Leave them nothing.
Beautiful face. Ooh, that's gotta hurt.
I mean, still definitely lose. You know, now we're down to three. So they just respond to my decimate. Wow, I was very confident, and we could lose this now. I don't know what I could have done differently, though. I mean, really, the only thing I could have done differently... they just drew another Ezreal. That was the card they just drew. The only thing I could have done differently was the transfusion. I messed up that transfusion. So that should have been a win if I would have just played transfusion correctly. Yeah, the Swain stuns got me. I could have probably waited on playing the 2-1, like waited to see if they, once they, cause they're probably not going to have like burst speed stun my 8-8. So have them stun the 8-8 and then play the 2-1 afterwards. Oh well, Lux Leona. Let's just keep our hand.
Bless the faithful and
I mean, I could have used Transfusion to kill Swain, yes. But what I did wrong was the one damage part to the ally. I did the one damage to the wrong thing. I put it on my 6-2 Overwhelm. I dealt one damage to it so that then they got to Ravenous Block it, and then they got to stay alive with that. I messed up my target. The deal one to an ally target of the Transfusion. But yeah, I could have gone after killing Swain as well.
The party has arrived.
I hope they don't have the 2-mana Solari card. That'd be the card that would punish me for playing the Draven first and not attacking first. Cool, they did not.
Daylight warms the heart and lights the way. Back, heretic.
Oh, I don't have any plan right now in particular to play the new lab, but yeah, I should probably do that, shouldn't I? I don't know exactly when that would be.
Daylight breaks on the battlefield. Behold the sun's holy light.
Fuse is lit!
Keep Transfusion and Might available and just attack. Why do I really need Might? I don't know.
Get in my way!
So 10, so I can do 5, 6, 7. So I could just kind of like go all out and put him down to 3.
You hoping they'll die of boredom?
It's probably not the best play.
Draven down.
Explosives primed.
I'll keep this in case we draw the 5-3 Nightfall. Okay, just another one drop. Pretty big correlation to games that we lose and all of our last draws being one drops. But we're pretty far ahead this time, so that's probably not going to be the case this time. Yep, saw one drops. Okay, so I know I can play the 2 gems, but I can also discard. So I can discard like both gems to the 2 spinning axes, so I can get pump spells at fast speed or burst speed, I guess. I could play one gem and have us discard the precious pet if we want to do that. We'll do that. We'll discard precious pet. Discard. Other thing. Cool. Glad not judgment. I wasn't playing around judgment. There's not really a way for us to play around judgment. Puts them down to 0. It's back on them to do something. Go all out. That does sound like a KDA KDA card. Finding that thing over there. Okay. Back to putting them down to zero. Okay, GG's. So 3-2. And maybe should have been a 4-1 if I would have just played the transfusion correctly. I think that probably would have been a 4-1. So, you know, another good showing there for Taric Draven. We only actually drew Taric in one game, and that one game Taric just dominated. I do think this is, like, the strongest card in the deck. Like, new Taric is really, really good, especially with these cards with Might, with Pale Cascade. Been really, really impressed with the new Taric, and unfortunately we only drew it one time, but I think that showed some pretty good strengths with the deck, where we still probably should have won three of the other four games, but I at least went 2-2, but I probably should have gone 3-1 in the other four games that we didn't have Taric. But, yeah, so that's Taric Draven. You want to be aggressive and play some cool support stuff and do some cool stuff in combat, and you want to play a Taric deck, give this one a try. I think this is a really strong Taric deck myself. All right, those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button over there, and of course, feel free to leave those comments as well. But thank you so much for watching some Taric Draven, and I'll see you for the next video.